We are here to reject fear.
We are here to reject fear. We are here to reject fear.
Come on.
Don't let's say violence.
Get a picture of you this year.
Police.
Hey, sir. Hey, how do you feel about these protesters? They calm?
Calm.
Good? Thanks, man.
C-51. It makes the racism more visible to target minorities like myself, who is an Aboriginal from South America, and many others, and directly targets activists like everyone here united in front of CISAS!
I didn't know this was
CISAS.
They're hiding behind their desk!
What? Wait.
On the side of the floor!
CISAS is here?
Are they?
It shows a lot of cojones around here.
Alright.
Okay, as a member of a group who opposes the police violence, which is typically based on race, gender identities,
ignorant.
Class, sexuality, disabilities, mental health, status, indigenous, immigration status, political beliefs, other genders, and other grounds or basis for identity. Brothers and sisters, victory is achievable. The members of the Neighbor Elimination of Police Violence, we are calling to every.
We are here to reject fear. We are here to reject fear. We are here to reject fear. We are here to reject fear.
It is my pleasure to now introduce Muhammad Ali, spoken word artist, and equally at home spitting raps on park benches or picket lines.
Park benches.
Yeah. How's everybody doing? Still feeling the energy? Story this morning. I was running late, took a cab to Nathan Phillips to the rally, left my phone in that taxi. If anybody takes a taxi today and sees a black iPhone, well, I guess you can't call me, but holler. But yeah,
taxi driver took it already.
And it's
already
right
sold.
Now driving around somewhere in the back of a taxi. But you know, we're here to defend our legal rights, our social rights, but our economic rights are also under attack. So what I'm going to do instead of sharing that piece that I had written is share a little bit about what I have to say to Stephen Harper, to the leaders that are not doing enough to defend our economic rights.
Yes!
Right here, some of y'all might know the original. It's called Solidarity Friendly.
Right on, he's gonna
like
do
this.
A rap, eh?
We used to work 9 to 5 and say the time flew by. Now we fighting over scraps like kitchen food flies. 2 jobs plus school, still too little. Minimum wage raised, but my rent got tripled. My boss at the cottage talking about austerity. Lounging on Muskoka chairs, he ain't trying to share with me. I say the economic action plan's an actual scam. After hand, the factory workers find their access banned. They turn this to a war between workers, bosses. Makes no sense, just furthers losses. Now we really see how much mergers costing. Say we get fired? No, not costing. Unite ourselves between the brain and the brawn. Solidarity forever till your breath is gone. All in together, sister, brother, sing a song. The union, yes, the union, the union makes us strong. All I know for sure, this wage in my pocket, always best protected by my trade union office. Real leaders, boots to the pavement. Puppet politicians, no longer complacent. Break stalemates, be the change agent. Rise to occasion, go and make a statement. We need change now, that's how we won the weekend. No dope or hope to hold the floor, for this is not the season. Life's no fairy tale, we have no night to slay the dragon. Your sword's a picket sign, it's time to strike action. We need to strike with words and fight for workers' rights and freedom. That real revolutionary, I write to be one. Unite ourselves between the brain and the brawn. Solidarity forever, till your breath is gone. All in together, sister, brother, sing the song. The union, yes, the union makes us strong. So I got one more short piece. Again, looking at our economic rights and what it's like dealing with these issues today, you know, as young workers, workers from across Canada, this one right here is called Precarious Work, and it goes a little something like this. Let's have a dialogue about private sector pirate laws. The right to work for less has got us in the fight for jobs. We sign a union cover probably because we're going haywire. This that hay market riot mob. Flipping burgers with a bachelor's degree. Serve it to you on my master's. What's the matter to me? Call me a millennial. Facebook status, Instagram addict, PlayStation, Xbox having. They tell me get a job. Okay, where's the job? You got some nerve, sir. Some wherewithal. Why you think graffiti kids is trying to mark the spot? You don't think we'd rather have a pension, a parking spot? You don't understand. Must be in the dark a lot. I can't even get an art interview at Target, dog. Yo, you work at Mickey D's? What's it like there? Starbucks? How's the child care? Is she babysat? Where your wages at? Rent, food, utilities, are you making that? Does your hard work seem to have an odd worth? Do your arms hurt? Damn, does your car work? Do you ride the train across the whole city map, spend the first 2 hours making that back? Now, how much are you worth as a whole? $11 an hour seem a little bit low? I mean, did you even know? Did you ever think if we all walked out, stores closing in a blink, all calling sick, who'd stop the shelves? Bosses took over with the